You know, I think that there's an element in which the artist and the lover in love share similar characteristics and sort of dispositions. There is a willingness to surrender. There is a willingness to give oneself to some higher meaning. There is something to be said for a different kind of truth, for subjectivity, for the truth as it plays out in your own head. I mean, science has been phenomenal at empirical investigations, at deconstructing the world into little bits and pieces and isolating the properties that constitute reality. That is all wonderful. But as Werner Herzog says, there's another kind of truth. There's ecstatic truth. It's a risk. You know, the artist has to take that risk. He has to put himself in a sort of state of heightened vulnerability. He has to disarm himself. Freeman Dyson talks about a new age of wonder in which literally a new generation of artists will be writing genomes with the fluency that Blake and Byron wrote verses. How might these technological instruments empower the artist, empower the imagination? We try to smash our sense of separateness and temples of fragmentation in a form of electronic Buddhism, the throbbing bass beats temporarily dissolving the self and allowing us to merge with the other. When we have sex, the Kama Sutra, people talk about blending into one another, becoming one another, entering the subjective headspace of the other. This is a wonderful idea. It reflects Richard Holmes's book, The Age of Wonder, where he talks about the 17th century where the artists and the scientists were friends, where the astronomers were poets. They talked about the importance of sort of interpretation, subjective experience.
Although people in many ways are afraid of that, they're afraid of letting go of their sort of individuated self. When you pop out the other side, it was the best thing you ever did, ultimately. Those things we fear the most end up being the greatest therapies. You know, life really does begin at the edge of your comfort zone. To take that leap, fall in love, or die trying.